It's the end of another week here at Train, and you know what that means.
Only 147 days left until summer.
Yes. But also, we have another inspiring and uplifting episode of VTV for you guys.
Let's go.
All right, let's get real. What's up with the new cell phone policy?
Not a fan. Not a fan.
Me neither, but supposedly it's good for us? Like broccoli?
I hate broccoli.
High schools across the U.S. are implementing a ban on cell phones in school. It is said that they are nothing but a distraction and they're no good to the student in a classroom.
The average high school student picks up their phones 58 times per day. Should this be classified as a distraction or a positive resource in the classroom?
It's become a rising dilemma whether phones are a positive resource or a distraction in the classroom. They hold the world's knowledge in the palm of one's hand, while also dinging and lighting up with notifications that can throw off the flow of a lesson.
I think it depends on the person. I think it could be a positive resource if the person uses it well.
I think that they can be used as a positive resource, but if used incorrectly, then they can be a negative resource.
I think phones is positive because it just makes me feel more safe, personally.
I think phones are positive because I think they're a great way to pass the time.
Phones are being banned in high schools across the U.S., and Triton may be near joining that trend. Phones have positive and negative impacts on students, so should students be able to have them in school?
Absolutely not. These things are a distraction, and these phones contribute not only to your ADD and ADHD, but mine as well. Can't go wrong with a book, a good old-fashioned book.
Yeah, I think students should be able to access their phones, but when there's instruction going on or when it's time that they should be put away, kids need to learn the difference between a time where they can have them and a time where it's time for instruction.
There is a huge variety of opinions on phones in school. Many people believe that phones are helpful, while many also think they can negatively affect students' production. While banning phones is an option, there's also many ways that we can fix this problem and make phones a great resource for students.
So phones serve a couple of different purposes. Sometimes they are tools that can be positive, and sometimes they are entertainment devices that can be negative in a classroom. And so if we're better about understanding when the phone is the tool that you want to use and the appropriate tool to use, then I think they have a lot of capabilities and could be really powerful learning devices.
Overall, it looks like there's hope for phones to remain in students' hands at Triton.
Phones are a great resource to have if they're properly maintained, so let's keep it that way. For VTV, I'm Wyatt.
And I'm Nate.
Okay, all right, see? I'm going to eat lunch now.
So, Mike, do you like your teachers this year?
They're all right.
What do you know about them?
Mr. Bono has a dog.
Okay.
It's got one blue eye, one brown eye, and his name's Tango.
That's fascinating stuff right there.
Yes, it is.
In our next segment, we asked some teachers if they share parts of their personal lives with their students. Here's what they said.
As the new school year begins, students are meeting their teachers, some old and some new.
Most students don't know anything about their teachers other than what they see during the school day.
So, do teachers have a life outside of school?
Some teachers might be willing to share personal information with their students, while some are more reserved.
What do you know about your teachers' lives outside of school?
I don't know much, but I do know that Mr. Richard does all the trivia for the 99 restaurants.
I don't know much about my teachers' lives outside of school, but some of the teachers are pretty cool.
Do you share facts with students about your life outside of school?
I do.
How much? To what extent do you share?
I think like any relationship that anybody has with another person, there are different degrees of what you share with people.
I do share a little bit of my personal life with my students. I do it because I'm trying to establish a friendly rapport with them. I think educationally it's important for students to feel comfortable to approach me with questions or to advocate for themselves. And I think they feel more comfortable doing that if they know me as a human being.
Lots of students are generally curious about what their teachers are like outside of school.
What do you wish you knew about your teachers' lives outside of school?
Kind of more of their hobbies, what they like to do, so I can kind of like maybe get to know them more.
I wish I knew why they always like are in a bad mood and give me bad grades, low-key.
I kind of wish they shared like what they did before teaching and like what they would do if they weren't teaching.
Students' lack of knowledge can be purposeful, and some suspect that teachers only let students know things on purpose, not letting them know the whole story about their life.
I believe that students should be allowed to know more about your life outside of school, or do you think that the amount that you tell them is enough?
I think it depends on the relationship with the student. Every person's an individual, and you should be able to be comfortable having a reciprocal sharing relationship back and forth between students.
I think as teachers, if we're asking students personal things about themselves to get to know them, that we should reciprocate and share those kinds of things with them as well.
Ultimately, students are curious about who their teachers are as people, and teachers have an opportunity to inspire their students by telling them more. For VTV, I'm Caleb.
And I'm Greg.
With homecoming right around the corner, Riley McIsaac decided to visit some recent Triton graduates to find out how their college experience is going.
Where are the Triton grads now? Over family weekend at St. Anselm College, Chris McIsaac, Liv Bateman, Kyle Renier, and Jared Leonard talk about college and how they spend their time. These grads all miss high school, but graduating was very exciting for them. Load of merch in that 12-passenger van in a small club in
Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I graduated in 2022.
Class of 2024.
I graduated in 2022.
I graduated in 2022.
Choosing a major is difficult to decide because it's the base of your future career. Thankfully, these grads enjoy what they picked to study and are very interested in it. Now that I'm here, wishing I was
still young. I'm a business and marketing double major. I chose that because it was the most interesting to me, and my family has roots to business and marketing.
I'm attending St. Anselm College as a finance major because I've always liked finance and numbers, so I kind of went that route.
My major is health sciences, and I decided to do it because I want to do physical therapy.
I'm behavioral neuroscience major with a minor in special education, and I chose that because I want to be an occupational therapist.
Some students have a good, memorable experience in high school, but some would prefer to just forget all of it.
I remember playing sports with all my friends and hanging out after.
Playing hockey with my friends.
I remember sporting games, hanging out with my friends, and Mr. Haley's math class.
Hanging out with my friends and chemistry with Dr. Lothra.
Overall, these alumni had a good experience at Triton, but have enjoyed the next stage in their life even more.
Earlier this week, my phone's weather app sent me a notification of a frost warning.
The weather is definitely changing again, and that means it's time for the warm clothes to come out of the closet.
It's also a great time to make some comfort food. Here's Neela Hurley with her hot chocolate chip cookie recipe.
Yum!
Hi,
Camila, and I'm here with my assistant, Cece, from Kentucky. And Cece, what are we making?
Chocolate
chip
cookies.
So let's go.
So Cece's actually going to set the mood first.
Never mind.
Oh, wait. What?
What am I doing? How we don't have a song. And he says, our song is the slam and scream door, sneak it out, it's tapping on your window when we're on the phone. So in a bowl, we're going to combine 2 1/4 cups flour and a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of kiss around the should have. And when so satisfying. At home for our sad amen. Okay, next we have butter, granulated sugar, brown sugar, and vanilla extract in a large mixer bowl until creamy.
Get your large mixer bowl! I was walking up the front porch
steps after everything that day had gone all wrong. So now we're gonna soften 2 sticks of butter. I got to the hallway, well on my way to my loving bed. I almost did. It's softened. The roses and the note that said, our song
is a flame of green doors. So now we're gonna add our dry ingredients to the bowl. And when I got home for our set. Well, for this mixing or like finishing mixing, I'm gonna drop the chips. This is what you're doing, probably.
What's that called?
If you do this, it makes them taste better. Okay, so we actually did all of them on my head, which is so awesome. So yeah.
Alexa, set a 10-minute timer.
10 minutes.
Depending on how big you make those cookies, they could take longer or shorter amount of time. Phone and he talks real slow, cause it's late and his mama don't know. Our song is the way he laughs. The first thing. Sir Taysers.
Hey Neela, if you need someone to taste test those cookies, hit me up.
Alright, our final segment is a music video produced by Abby and Julia to the song Brand New by Ben Rector. Enjoy! Like a brand new pair of jeans. I feel like taking chances. I feel a lot like 17. When I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing, like I can fly and don't even think of touching the ground, like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way that I feel when I'm with you. Brand new. Like making big mistakes. I feel like for the first time in a long time I am not afraid. I feel like a kid. Never thought it'd feel like this. Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me.
Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. Like I can't fly and I don't even think I'm touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way that I feel when I'm with you. Brand new.
There you go. VTV episode 2 in the books.
Thank you all for watching our show.
Until next week,
keep your cheese drippy. No, we're grinding. We're locked in. I like broccoli uncooked.
I think a little less enthusiasm.
Bobby L, Mr. Bob Lathrop, man, dude, guy, mister. You are my fire. I want it that way.
Tell me why.
Ain't nothing but a mistake. To find out how their college experience is going. Get out my shot.
Mike, you're the only one on this one, so.
On God, practice. I'm locked.
You're locked?
You're not locked.
No, you're not.
On God, I'm locked.
All right, reread it.
What's the difference between a regular chocolate chip and a hot chocolate chip?
One's warmer than the other.
Oh. Yum. Bro, I just want some cookies at this point.
Our final oh my God.
You're ruining it.
Until next week.
Keep your cheese drippy.
Drip versus stick.
I like my cheese drippy, bruh.
Yes,